Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. In the previous problem, we did a Euler's method approximation of this function at y of 1, and the answer we got was 2.182381, which we rounded to 2.18. They've also asked us to check our answer by actually solving the equation and computing y of 1, which will give us an exact answer. So it'll be interesting to see, well, probably interesting to me and not to any of you, but interesting to see how the exact answer, how much it will differ from the Euler's method approximation. So let's go ahead and check it another way. We're actually going to solve the equation this time. So what we're going to do is, first of all, convert y prime here to dy over dx, which is the same thing, and we get x over y. And just as in differential equations problems, what we need to do is first separate the variables. So we'll multiply both sides by dx and get dy equals x over y times dx. Then we'll multiply both sides by y, which will move the y over to the left side, and we'll be left with y dy equals x dx. So now that we've separated variables, we have y's on the left and x's on the right. Step two is integrating both sides of the equation. So we integrate like this, and now integrating, we will use the power rule. We'll add 1 to the exponent. I'll put this up here, and we'll get y squared, and then divide the coefficient, which is a 1, by the new exponent, which is 2. So we get 1 half y squared equals 1 half x squared, and then we're going to add c to the right side of the equation. So we've integrated, and now what we want to do if we can is try to solve for y. So we'll multiply both sides of the equation by 2. That'll cancel out the 1 half on both sides, and we'll have y squared equals x squared plus 2c. And remember that c is a different kind of thing. It's an aggregator of the constants in the function, so we're going to end up solving for c. Once we solve for y, we're going to plug in the initial condition here and solve for c. So c is going to kind of accumulate constants together. So let's go ahead and leave it for now. It's somewhat confusing, but we're going to take the square root of both sides of the equation to get this y on its own. So we'll get y equals the square root of x squared plus 2c. And now what we'll do is go ahead and plug in the initial condition, y of 0 equals 2. So we'll plug in we'll plug in 0 for x and 2 for y. So we'll get 2 equals the square root of 0 squared plus 2c. And now what we can do is, of course, this 0 is going to cancel, so we'll be left with 2 equals the square root of 2c. We can go ahead and square both sides to get rid of the square root, since we're solving for c, and we'll get 4 equals 2c. We divide both sides by 2, and we get 2 equals c. So now that we've solved for c and gotten 2, we can plug in 2 into our equation, which we found here. You want to plug it in wherever it was that you had solved for y. So not into this equation, because we're still here at y squared, but into the one where you solved for y. So we plug in c, we plug in 2 for c, and we get y equals the square root of x squared plus, and when we plug in 2 here for c, we'll get 2 times 2, which is 4. So that is our equation for y, we went ahead and solved the differential equation. But now we need to, just as with Euler's method in the previous video, we approximated y of 1. Now we want to, since we've solved the equation, plug in 1 for x and get the actual answer. So we'll go ahead and do that here, and we'll get y equals the square root of 1 squared plus 4. So of course that means we have y equals the square root of 5. So when we take the square root of 5 on our calculator, the answer that we get is 6067798. So you can see, and then if we do Euler's 2.182381. So you can see here, Euler's method was an approximation, 2.18. This here, y of 1, is the actual value at 2.236. So you can see they're off by about 0.05. So the Euler's method approximation gets us fairly close, but is still off considerably, noticeably, from the actual value, which is this 2.24, so rounded. So hope that gave you guys some clarification about the difference between, you know, actually solving the equation and getting the exact value versus using the Euler's method approximation. See you guys next time. Bye!